Hello, my name is Taylor Ellis. I am the Assessment Coordinator at Scholarship Prep, a TK through 8th grade charter school in Southern California. This video is about loading accessibility resources into TOMS. So at Scholarship Prep, when we're loading accessibility resources into TOMS, we kind of think of it in two buckets. So we work with our special education department to make sure that all accessibility resources that are accommodations outlined in students' IEPs are uploaded. And so I do that from the central office, and I work with our special education department to pull their reports from SACE or from Welligent and ensure that all of the accommodations outlined in their IEPs are uploaded into TOMS. For that initial upload, I utilize it's a CSV, I believe, upload. And that way we have, you know, everybody in there from the get-go. What's nice about this is that then those accessibility resources are also available for any interim assessments that teachers use throughout the year. And so we really make sure to do it pretty early on. As IEPs happen throughout the school year and accommodations are changed, then I have special education teachers or case carriers let me know what changes need to be adjusted. And I go in and manually adjust those one-on-one. Our LEA is fairly small. And so it is... I have the capacity to do that. I also occasionally will tap in our site coordinators to help support with some of those adjustments because sometimes handling one school can be easier than handling four. The second bucket of accessibility resources that we upload into TOMS, I also do initially through a spreadsheet, but those are our designated supports that teachers work with their teams to identify students who might need some of those designated support. And so similarly, we upload those through the spreadsheet. Those we don't do in the very beginning of the school year because we wait until the second semester after teachers have had an opportunity to get to know their students and really identify what designated supports will be appropriate for each of their kiddos. So that set of supports gets uploaded at the end of December or the beginning of January. And that way students have the opportunity with their teachers to practice utilizing some of those designated supports that are available to them. And it also allows for teachers to determine if those really are appropriate after, you know, some practice, if you will, on interim assessments or through the practice site. Thanks so much for watching. I hope you found this information timely and useful.